when one looks at what's happening in Western Europe now, and I would guess what's happening here, one of the things that one notices is that people somehow have come to find democracy inefficient. There is some way in which, sometimes I think actually that the single greatest democratic virtue is patience.
Yeah.
Because, not only because of the complexity of the issues and the complexity of the structure of governments that are required to address these issues, but also because if you are going to have checks and balances, you are going to slow things down to the point at which citizens may find their governments emotionally unsatisfying.
If you want efficiency, then have an authoritarian.
That's correct. Right.
And oh, by the way, though, if you're going to be omnipotent, all-powerful, you'd also better be omniscient, all-knowing.
Yes.
And one of the problems for... God
understood that.
Yes, yes. That's right. That doesn't need to be a democracy. Yes. But in any case, if you are an authoritarian, you can act quickly.
Yes.
But democracies make actually fewer big mistakes. So the Chinese very quickly instituted something called the one-child policy. And now 30 million Chinese males don't have mates. So... You sometimes in democracies we do, and then look, I'm frustrated too with the slowness sometimes, and what are they doing in Washington, and why don't they move along? But particularly in the case of American democracy, the founding fathers intended for the system to move slowly.
Yeah.
And incrementally. Madison was famous for saying that nobody should ever permanently lose in a democracy. So the first time we have a policy dispute, maybe I'll win that round, but I don't want to completely defeat you because I'm going to need you the next time around when we move to some other policy issue. And so, of course, it can be frustrating, but far preferable to the authoritarian who is omnipotent but not really omniscient.
Right. Well, here we may be... breaking new ground in this taxonomy, and we may develop a kind of bumbling authoritarianism.